Hello friends, welcome to YouTube channel Electronics. In this video, we will discuss about one of the most widely used IC of all time, that is 555 timer IC. We will discuss how it works and its internal design in detail. 555 timer ICs can produce timing signals of varying pulse width. It can produce accurate time delays like here. When you press a button, the output will goes high for a certain controllable time period. 555 timer IC is very useful in timing related applications like alarm generators, frequency dividers and relaxation oscillators and etc. The 555 timer ICs are commercially available in many packages. But here we will discuss most commonly used package, that is 8-pin DIP package. The pin configuration of 555 timer IC is specified here. Each pin performs a specific function. Let's observe the internal block diagram. It consists of various functional blocks that work together to generate timing pulses. Here is the internal circuit diagram of 555 timer. It consists of 25 transistors, 2 diodes and 16 resistors. If we represent this schematic diagram with a block diagram, it consists of a voltage divider marked with violet color, 2 comparators marked in green, a flip-flop colored in blue, a discharge transistor colored in orange and an output stage in red color. So let's see the function of each block and each pin. Here the pin number 8 is VCC or supply voltage and pin number 1 is ground. The supply voltage between these two pins are usually in the range of 4.5 volts to 16 volts. If you observe over here, a voltage divider circuit is in between VCC and ground pin. It is the first stage of the 555 timer IC. The voltage divider is made using 3 5 kilo ohm resistors. Because of the same value resistors, the entire applied VCC will get equally divided between each resistor. So by applying voltage divider rule, we can say that the voltage at this node is equal to 1 by 3 VCC and the voltage at this node is equal to 2 by 3 VCC. For example, if our VCC is 6 volts, then we will get 4 volts at one node and 2 volts at other node. Let's get back to our block diagram. Here the voltage at this node is 2 by 3 VCC and the voltage at this node is 1 by 3 VCC. Here two reference voltages are gets created and these reference voltages are fed to the second stage, that is comparator stage. 555 timer IC have two comparators. Apart from these two reference voltages, two inputs, threshold and trigger pins 6 and 2 also connected to these two comparators. A comparator have two inputs. First one non-inverting input denoted with plus symbol. Second one inverting input denoted with minus symbol and it gives only one output. A comparator compares its two input voltages and gives an output of high or low voltage depending on which input voltage is higher. If the input voltage at non-inverting or positive terminal is greater than its inverting or negative terminal, the output of the comparator will be high or logic 1. If the inverting or negative input is greater than non-inverting or positive input, the output goes low or logic 0. Let's come back to our diagram. Here the inputs for the upper or first comparator are a reference voltage of 2/3 VCC which is connected to inverting or minus input and the threshold pin 6 is connected to the non-inverting or plus input. So if the threshold input is greater than 2/3 VCC, then the first comparator output becomes high. Likewise, if the threshold input is lesser than 2/3 VCC, then the first comparator output becomes low. On the other hand, the inputs to the lower or second comparator are A reference voltage of 1/3 VCC is connected to the non-inverting or positive input, and the trigger pin 2 is connected to the inverting or minus input. So if the trigger input is lesser than 1/3 VCC, then the second comparator output becomes high. Likewise, if the trigger input is greater than 1/3 VCC, then the second comparator output becomes low. So by using these threshold and trigger inputs, we can control the outputs of the comparator, which are then fed to the next stage, that is flip-flop stage. Here it is a SR flip-flop. A SR flip-flop consists two inputs and two outputs. Here S stands for set and R stands for reset. The outputs of the flip-flop are Q and Q bar respectively, where Q and Q bar are the complements of each other. So let's see the truth table of SR flip-flop. SR flip-flop is a digital circuit. Hence, it has two stable states, either logic 1 or logic 0. By observing the truth table step by step, we can easily know the working of SR flip-flop. In case 1, whenever the both inputs S and R are 0, then the output of the flip-flop will be same as its previous state, that is no change in output. In case 2, whenever set input is 0 and reset input is 1, then the SR flip-flop gets reset. So the Q output becomes 0 and its inverse output Q bar becomes 1. Likewise, in case 3, whenever set input is 1 and reset input is 0, then the flip-flop sets its Q output to 1 and its complementary output Q bar becomes 0. In case 4, whenever both inputs set and reset are logic 1 simultaneously, at that time the flip-flop leads to undesired behavior known as forbidden or invalid state. So in SR flip-flops, only these three input conditions are used. The last condition must be avoided. Let's get back to our 555 timer block diagram. Here the flip-flop's inputs R and S fed from the comparator's output, and these comparators are comparing threshold and trigger inputs from the reference voltages of 2/3 and 1/3 VCC values respectively. For example, here the input conditions are S is logic 0 and R is logic 1. So output Q becomes logic 0, but this output is not used in 555 timer, and the other output Q bar becomes logic 1. This Q bar output connected to next stage, that is output stage. It is an inverter which can either source or sink a maximum current of 200 milliamperes to the load. An inverter is a logic device that has an output opposite to its input. Sometimes it is referred as NOT gate. For example, if we apply a logic high input, it gives logic low output. And if we apply a logic low input, and it gives logic high output. In 555 timer block diagram, output stage consists an inverter. Here our inverter input is logic high, so it gives logic low at the output. If we observe over here, it is just equal to SR flip-flop's Q output. So by changing the threshold voltage level above or below the reference voltage of 2/3 VCC, we can change the output state of the first comparator. That will make the flip-flop's Q bar output to change. The output stage will invert this, and the final output of the 555 timer will be changed. So by this threshold voltage, we are controlling the output voltage. And same thing can be done by changing this trigger voltage level above or below the reference voltage of 1/3 VCC. So by using this threshold and trigger pins, we can control the output voltage level. One more important stage of the 555 timer is the discharge function. It is responsible for discharging the external timing capacitor. Let's see how this discharge process happens. Whenever we get flip-flop's inputs R is high and S is low, the flip-flop gives outputs Q is low and Q bar is high. So the base of the internal transistor gets high level because it is directly connected to the flip-flop's Q bar output. This transistor is a NPN transistor. So it turns on and acts as a closed switch. Hence the external timing capacitor which is connected to this discharge pin gets discharged through this internal transistor. This discharge process is an essential step for the capacitor to reset and prepare for the next timing cycle. By controlling this discharge function, we can adjust the timing of the 555 timer. Another critical pin of 555 timer IC is the reset pin. Here this dot indicates it is an active low input, which means it is triggered when the voltage at this pin goes low. The flip-flop gets reset, so the output Q becomes logic low and Q bar becomes logic high. Due to inverter stage at the output, the 555 timer's output becomes logic low. The 555 timer output stays at logic low level irrespective of the whatever the inputs it is getting from the comparator stage. So whenever this pin is not in use, then it should be connected to the supply voltage so that reset pin will always get logic high level and the reset function will be disabled. Finally, we will discuss about control pin function. This control pin is very useful in controlling the timing of 555 timer. This pin is internally connected to inverting terminal of the first comparator and there is reference voltage of 2/3 VCC connected to this pin. So by applying an external voltage to this pin, we can change the 2/3 and 1/3 VCC reference voltage levels from 45% to 90% of the supply voltage. This enables us to vary the timing of the output signal. If this pin is not used, it should be connected with a 10 nanofarad decoupling capacitor to ground to ensure electrical noise doesn't affect the internal voltage divider. So by using this control threshold and trigger pins, we can change the timing of the output signal. Now let's see operating modes of 555 timer IC. It can be operated in three modes: Astable, Bistable and Monostable. In Astable mode, 555 timer works as an electronic oscillator or free running multivibrator. To design an Astable multivibrator using 555 timer IC, just take two resistors and one capacitor. Connect them in series as shown here. Connect the capacitor end to ground and connect the resistor end to VCC. Now connect discharge pin 7 to the junction point between R1 and R2. Next, interconnect threshold pin 6 and trigger pin 2. Connect this to the junction of resistor and capacitor. We don't want to use reset function, so connect reset pin 4 to VCC. We don't want to use control function, so connect pin 5 with a 10 nanofarad capacitor to the ground. Now when the power is turned on, the output of the circuit continuously switches between logic low state to logic high state. So it generates continuous pulses. The time period of this pulse is given by the expression T equals to 0.7 into R1 plus 2 into R2 multiplied with C1. So by choosing appropriate values of resistor R1, R2 and capacitor C1, we can construct a desired frequency free running multivibrator. Now let's design a bistable multivibrator using 555 timer IC. A bistable multivibrator has two stable states, high and low. It stays in the same state until and unless an external trigger input is applied. To design a bistable circuit, just take two resistors R1 and R2, connect them with VCC as shown here. Connect other end of the resistors R1 and R2 with two switches S1 and S2 respectively, and connect the remaining end of the switches S1 and S2 to ground as shown here. Now join the reset pin 4 between R1 and S1 and join the trigger pin 2 between R2 and S2. Now when you turn on this circuit, initially the output is at logic low level because both switches S1 and S2 are open. When we close the trigger switch S2, the output of the circuit changes to logic low level to logic high level. The output stays at high state even after we release this switch S2. Now when we close the reset switch S1 for a momentary duration, the output switches back to low level. The output stays at this low state until unless we again close the switch S2. Hence this circuit have two stable states. So it is working like a bistable multivibrator. Now let's see how to design monostable multivibrator using 555 timer IC. A monostable multivibrator have only one stable state, logic high or logic low. When monostable circuit triggered externally, it changes its state for short duration and return back to its original state. To design a monostable circuit, just take two resistors R1 and R2, connect them to the VCC. Connect the other end of the resistor R1 to a capacitor C1, but the other end of the resistor R2 to switch S1. Join the other ends of switch S1 and capacitor C1 to ground. Now connect the threshold and discharge pins 6 and 7 to the junction between R1 and C1 and trigger pin 2 to the junction between R2 and S1. When we turn on this circuit, initially the output stays at logic low level because switch S1 is open. When we close the switch S1, the output changes its state to logic high level and holds there for a specific time duration and changes back to its original state logic low level. The time duration of this pulse is decided by the values of the externally connected resistors R1, R2 and capacitor C1. This time period T is calculated by the following relation. T equals to 1.1 into C1 into R1. So we can increase or decrease the period of the output pulse by increasing or decreasing the values of resistors R1 and capacitor C1 respectively. So this is how we can design astable, bistable and monostable multivibrators using 555 timer IC. We will discuss how the 555 timer functions in different operating modes in detail in upcoming video. That's all about internal design and working of 555 timer IC. If you have learned from this video, please do mention them in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please click the like button. Help others to learn by sharing this video. Please subscribe and turn on notifications for more such videos. Have a nice day.